Hello, let's look at the strategies for policy plan implementation. Now, the first strategy is pilot study implementation. Once you have planned out, the first thing you need to do is to pilot test your plan to see where you need to improve upon and if there are areas of gap that you need to beef up. Secondly, you have to schedule movement of resources and mobilize mobilization and public enlightenment about the policy that has been formulated. In this way, we have to think of who should be mobilized. Those that need to be mobilized are those that are going to benefit from it, the stakeholders for that policy, those that will benefit, those that will use it, and those that will gain from it, or those that will provide the resources, all need to be mobilized. Their strategies for mobilization could be using the beneficiaries, that is the people, or the community leaders, religious leaders, political leaders, traditional rulers, or the parents teacher association. In addition, you could equally use mass media. Then another factor is the manpower recruitment, because once you have been able to map out the implementation plan, the next thing is to recruit manpower. Like I mentioned in one of my videos, you discover that when the manpower is not there, the plan will likely fail. Like what happened in Nigeria with the 6334. The 6334 system of education failed because the manpower was not planned along with the implementation plan. It was at the point of implementation, it was, oh, we don't have manpower that would drive this equipment that has been brought. So it affects. So you have to recruit the manpower that are going to drive it. Then you have to come up with the enabling law. The law that will serve as a guide, the law that will help to protect what is in place, then set up the minimum standard that needs to be followed. What will be the minimum standard that will help to enhance quality in that particular area? Then the data collection analysis. When you collect data, especially in the area of evaluation or pilot testing, how are you going to analyze it? What are the mechanisms that have been put in place that will help you carry out such analysis? Then planning for facilities and equipment that need to be used to carry out such plans. And if the facilities are not available, the equipment are not available, the manpower are there, then it will still fail. So it needs to put in place the necessary facilities and equipment. Then we have to put in place the monitoring and evaluation mechanism. The monitoring and evaluation mechanism is very vital because the monitoring will help to see whether what is being done is done according to plan, is done according to specification. And the evaluation will help to put in the value of what has been done, and that will help to determine the exact achievement that have been reached using that particular plan. Then you need funding. The funding is very vital because without funds, you will not be able to do every other thing that has been mentioned. If you want to recruit, you need funds. If you want to provide facilities, you need funds. If you want to sustain, you need funds because people are going to meet, people are going to see that you're going to transport, they're going to take care of their cost, are you going to feed them? So everything needs money. And lastly, we have to look at the introduction of motivational packages, because if you want a particular policy to strive, you must have something on ground that will help to motivate the stakeholders. And once they are motivated, be rest assured that policy will survive.